Probably all of us have looked into a clear night sky in a moment of reflection and asked, where do the stars come from? Where does the universe end? How did it all begin? These questions have prompted past astronomers to peer through their telescopes in hopes of possible clues to answer these age-long mysteries. They hope to explain who we are and where we came from. In this creation, we will explore the question of how the universe began. And in this century, scientific findings have pointed to one overwhelming conclusion. The universe began with a big bang. But at the turn of the century, astronomers viewed the universe as one big galaxy, the Milky Way, as infinite space and infinite time. No beginning, no end. Everything changes, but over long, long periods of time. Then in 1913, certain astronomical discoveries began to unravel the mystery of the universe. Dr. Robert Jastrow, founder of NASA's Goddard Institute of Space Studies, explains.
It all started in 1913 when Slipher, an American astronomer looking for something else, stumbled across the fact that most of the galaxies in our neighborhood are moving away from us and from one another at very high speeds, ranging up to millions of miles an hour. And he did not understand the significance of his own finding.
Edwin Hubble, an American astronomer at California's Mount Wilson, took Slipher's information and found that the galaxies were indeed expanding at incredible speeds. While the Americans collected data from telescopes, the Europeans formulated universes in their heads. At the center of this thinking was Albert Einstein with his theory of relativity. His equations made mankind see the universe differently, in more complex and changing terms. 2 years later, a Dutch astronomer named De Sitter predicted an expanding universe from Einstein's equations. A new picture of the universe was emerging. If the galaxies were expanding, as both physics and astronomy had proven, then the universe was not eternal. It had a beginning. If it had a beginning, then what was it like?
Many scientists resisted the implication that the world began with a bang. They didn't mind the bang, but they resisted the idea that there was a beginning to the universe. Because as Einstein, it was Einstein's feeling that if the universe had a beginning, a singularity in time is what Einstein called it. A singularity in time, Einstein said, he used these words, irritates me. I find it nonsensical. Now, why did one aspect of his theory irritate Einstein more than another? It suggested there are forces at work outside the body of science.
The Big Bang theory was debated for decades until 1965, when two Bell Lab physicists named Wilson and Penzias stumbled onto some celestial static they could not explain. That static was later proven to be cosmic background radiation, or the residue of heat and light left over from the initial fireball at the birth of the universe.
The discovery of that radiation that fills the universe and looks like the remnant of the primordial fireball is, in my view and that of many other scientists, one of the most important discoveries ever made in our field in its 3 or 4 centuries since the time of Galileo and Newton, because it shows that the world had a beginning, and that beginning was very different from the state of the world today. And that produces questions as to who created the universe or who began this chain of events that carry us to the very limits of science and perhaps beyond its limits.
Now, theologians are delighted with the proof that the universe had a beginning, but astronomers are uncomfortable. One astronomer said, I would like to reject the Big Bang theory, but I have to face the facts. Astronomers are uncomfortable with the association of the Big Bang with Genesis 1:1, in which it says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Today's astronomers are evading the big question, who lit the fuse?
And now they have a grand effect, the existence of the universe. And they cannot find the cause, because the very circumstances of the beginning of the universe have dropped a curtain over the mystery of its creation. There is no way within the realm of science that they can penetrate through that barrier provided by the physical conditions that existed at and near the Big Bang. And so they're in the position of a group of mountaineers that have been painfully climbing a series of peaks, one after the other, rising closer and closer to the ultimate truth in their profession. And as they ascend the final peak and come out onto the mountaintop, they find there a band of theologians who have been occupying that position for centuries.
That's creation. With the 700 Club, I'm David Sisson.